Hi, my name is PK Gulati. I'm the founder of The Assembly. If you're here, you're probably watching an Assembly workshop. We do these workshops every week, and these are prepared by the Assembly team in Dubai. These workshops cover ideas from data sciences, hardware design, automation, robotics, drones, and all the other exponential technologies that you can think about. The idea is for us to learn more than what curriculum teaches us. And we are trying to bring people to start working with their own hands with these technologies which have the capacity of changing the world. So welcome to this workshop and learn more about new wonders, what you can build.
Hi everyone, this is Abhi. Welcome to another Assembly workshop. Today we're gonna make a COVID density map using Mapbox API. Why do we need this program? Because the world that we live in is very interconnected and the boundaries and borders are very blurred. So no one really has the luxury of being limited to the place they live in. If anything is affecting one part of the world, then it is not very far from affecting you as well. The pandemic has taught us that it is important to be aware of the events and happenings all over the globe. This map is an attempt towards that cause, as it plots the daily updated COVID data available on any online websites on the world map. And it highlights the places with higher cases of corona and displays the details like the number of positive cases, number of recovered cases, and the number of deaths. Before we start with the workshop, let me introduce you to the Assembly. The Assembly is a smart lab based in N5 since December 2014. We have conducted over 300 workshops, and our workshops have three main topics, which are Hack, which includes embedded systems, IoT, and hardware, Code, which is all the software projects related to different kinds of APIs, frameworks, and apps, and the Data Science workshops, which deals with advanced topics related to AI and machine learning. Our target audience are students, professionals, and entrepreneurs, but anyone who is interested in our workshops is more than welcome to attend. You can follow us on our forum, members.theassembly.ae, or on any of our social media pages, which is Twitter, Instagram, or YouTube. So let's get on with the workshop. In this workshop, we will be collecting COVID data from any online websites. And since the online websites has a lot of unnecessary information, we will be condensing the data. Then we will proceed on to make our own very basic web page to convert the Excel data obtained into a JSON object. And we'll use that data to make another web page, which plots it and puts it on the world map. I'd like to talk a little about Mapbox. Mapbox is an American provider of custom online maps for websites and applications such as Foursquare, Lonely Planet, and Snapchat. The startup was created as a part of Development Seed in order to offer map customization for nonprofit customers in 2010. Since 2010, it has rapidly expanded the niche of custom maps as a response to the limited choice offered by map providers such as Google Maps. The Mapbox web service APIs allows you to access Mapbox tools and services. You can use these APIs to upload and change resources and use the core Mapbox tools. Mapbox APIs are divided into four distinct services: maps, navigations, search, and accounts. Each of these services has its own APIs which make up the service. We are going to be using the map service in today's workshop. I'd also like to talk about JSON files, which is JavaScript Object Notation. It is a standard text-based format for representing structured data based on JavaScript object syntax. Even though it closely resembles JavaScript object literal syntax, it can be used independently from JavaScript, and many programming environments feature the ability to read and generate JSON. It is commonly used for transmitting data in web applications, like sending some data from the server to client so it can be displayed on a web page, or vice versa. We will be using JSON object to take data from any online resource and plot it on our map. So let's begin with the workshop. To start with the workshop, we need COVID-related data. So we need the confirmed cases, the deaths, the recovered people, their regions, and their coordinates. To get that, we can access any online resource. What I'm using is data.humdata.org. it updates daily the required information, and it has the Excel documents which we need to download. So when we download these, we'll find out that it also has a lot of unnecessary information, like the cases from like past year. So we don't need them. So what we have to do over here is condense the data, like I have done over here, so that we only have the region, the coordinates, and the confirmed cases, the deaths, and the recovered. So after we've done all of this, we need to create a basic web page to convert our Excel document into a JSON file. So what I've done here is I've created a basic web page which has two buttons which we'll use to upload our file into the web page and then convert it into a JSON object. In this web page, I have created three classes: input, button, and JSON data. We'll use the input and button classes to take the file from the user's desktop and convert it into a JSON object. And then we'll use the JSON data class with ID JSON data to store this data and then display it on the web page. So all we need to do now is add JavaScript to this web page and then write the code to convert an Excel document into the JSON object in that JavaScript. So we'll name the JavaScript excel.js, and we'll also add a accept parameter to the input class input so that it accepts only Excel documents. So now we'll move on to writing the code for excel.js, and over here we'll declare a variable selected file which we'll use to store our file. Then we'll add event listeners for both our buttons, which is the input and the button. So get element by ID. Add the event listener. Now we'll store the file that the user has selected into our variable selected file using event.target.files. So it will get the selected file and then store it into our selected file variable. Then what we'll do is we'll create another event listener for our class with ID button, and we'll change this event as a click event. So when you click on it, it changes your Excel file into a JSON object. And we'll write over here that if selected file is true, then we'll use a file reader to read the file. And we'll read our selected file as a binary string. Now if we want to see our result, we'll use file reader dot onload event, and then we'll add a console dot log, and we'll use event dot target dot result to display our result. If we run the web page, we should see our Excel document as a binary string. So when we run the web page, we choose our file, we convert it, and when we inspect, we see that our Excel file has been converted into a binary string. Now what we need to do is, we need to install a third-party library called XLXX SX, which has features like sheet.js, which we can use to convert our Excel document into a JSON file. So what we'll do is we'll go to CDN.js and we'll search for XLSX, and over here what we need for our web page to convert Excel into JSON is xlsx.full.min.js. So what we'll do is we'll copy this URL and we'll go back to our web page and we'll add a script tag below title src equal to, and we'll paste our the CDN version of the XLSX library over here. So now we can use it on our web page. So we'll go back to our Excel document and we'll create a variable called data, and we'll store our result, the binary string that we obtained, into this variable. So after that, we can use the XLSX library to convert our binary string into JSON object. So what we'll do is we'll use the library to read the data, the binary data, and we'll do a console.log. We'll see if our program has made the changes or not. So we'll convert and we'll inspect. So as we can see in our the workbook part has read it, and it contains 201 strings. That means that our XLSX has read the Excel document, and we can now use the sheet.js part of XLSX to convert our Excel document into the JSON object. So what we'll do is we'll write workbook.sheetNames dot for, and we'll declare a variable called row object. So what this variable does is it stores each row of the Excel document as a separate JSON file. So we'll then use the XLSX library, and we'll use the sheet to row object array function, the method of XLSX library. So now we'll add console.log to see if the rows of our Excel file are being converted into JSON, individual JSON objects, or not. So when we run our web page again, we should be able to see individual row JSON objects created for our Excel file. So when we inspect, we have an error. So the error is we have forgot to add row. It's a row object. So if we execute this now, and if we choose the file, and if we inspect, then as you can see, we have obtained our array, and in this array all these rows have been converted into individual JSON objects. So now all that we need to do is store these in our JSON data variable. We need to store this in our JSON data variable. And we'll store it as a JSON string, complete JSON string. So all the individual JSON strings will be stored under a like a complete JSON string. So we'll use the JSON stringify feature of xlsx.js, and we'll pass the pass its attributes as row object, and when we choose the file in our web page, we can see that our JSON data has been displayed. But this is all in one line, so we would like to see it in a better way. So what we do is we add parameters undefined, comma, the spacing, which should be 4. And if we open this with Live Server, and so our Excel document has been converted into a JSON object. Now we need to copy this JSON data and put it in another file, which I've created, COVID A. So I'll create a new file in this, name it as data.json. And in this, I will create a curly brackets and store it as a JSON object so that I can access it using the data variable. So I'll go over here, I'll convert it again, then I'll copy the whole JSON object. So now we have our JSON file and we need to plot it on the map. So now that we have obtained our JSON data, we can continue on to make our new web page. This web page will take this data.json, use mapbox.api and plot it onto the world map. So we'll name this as map.html and write the basic code for the HTML document, and we'll name it as create your own Corona map. Now what we need to do in this web page is add mapbox.api to it. So what we'll do is we'll go to mapbox. If you haven't created an account on mapbox API, mapbox.com, then I suggest you do that. And if and when you've done the created the account, you need to go to your account and you need to click on mapbox.gl.js. Okay, so when you go to this mapbox.gl.js, you'll get some documentation. This documentation you take from here and you add it onto your maps, because this will help you use the Mapbox API into your web application. So we took this and we'll also copy this. We would also need to put this link file up beneath the title. So we'll drag it up in the below the title. And we'll put the div in the body of the document. So now if we run map.html, we can see that our map has been loaded onto the web page, but it is very small and we need to enlarge in it. So what we'll do is in the head of the document, we'll go and we'll style the document according to our, I mean, you can style it according to your own thing. I'm just giving it a basic style. So for the page, I'll keep the margin and the padding as 0. And for the map, we'll increase the width and height of the map to spread the whole page. So what we'll do is we'll keep the width as 100, viewport width, and we'll keep the height as 100, viewport height so that it spans the whole page. So if we save this and if we run the web page again, we can see that it is not spanning the whole page. It's because of the fact that we have used some inline CSS which the Mapbox documentation had used. So if we remove that and if we run it, we can see that now our map spans the whole page. So now it's zooming in on somewhere in the US. So we can change the zoom to somewhere in the middle, and we can change the zoom to something like 1. So if we run it again, we can see that we can see the whole world map. Now, since we have no idea what this world map is about, we can style the web page a little more. So what we'll do is we'll add another div class in body, and we'll add a title to the page on this in this div class. So the title could be, we'll keep the heading as h4, and the title could be Corona Density Map. We can also style our heading a little by adding a style tag, and in this tag we'll style the header class. We'll keep the padding as 10 pixels. I think that should do. I think we'll keep the text align to the center because that's how headings look. That's how our heading will look good. We'll keep the background as I would like a purple color. You can keep whatever you want. So the code for purple is 601 ABC. See, the purple color has appeared. I would like the color, keep to the color of the heading as, I mean, it looked good. And the font size would be 30px. So if we save this and run our map, then our map looks something like this. So we have created the map. Now all we need to do is add the markers on the map from using our JSON data, and display the details on the markers of the COVID details of any area. So now that we have created the map, we'll now add markers to the map. These markers will be the data that we obtained from the JSON file. So they'll be plotted along their to their coordinates and the region, and they'll show they'll have a pop-up attached to them which will show the confirmed cases, the deaths, and the recovered. So first what we'll do is we'll add a script tag to our web page, and we'll connect a JavaScript to our web page where we'll write the code for adding the maps. So we'll name this file map.js. Then we'll go on and write the code for adding the markers to the map. Basically, we're creating this function, and this function will update our map. And we'll also declare this function in this JavaScript. Then we'll use the fetch API to fetch the data that we had converted, the data.json file. So we'll use the fetch API to, so we'll write /data.json, and this will fetch the JSON file in this JavaScript. So What happens is fetch API is it returns a promise. So to resolve this promise, you have to declare two dot then statements. So we'll write our response dot JSON, and this will be in the second dot then statement we'll write a console dot log to see if our data is being loaded or not. So if we run this, we should see our data in the console. See our data, we have loaded our data onto the map. Now what we need to do is we need to plot it. So for plotting, we'll declare two variables. First, what we need to do is we need to run a for loop so that not only one marker is marked, all of the markers are marked simultaneously. And in this for loop, we'll declare two variables, lat, which will be equal to the latitude of the row object, and long, which will be equal to longitude of the row object. Then we'll add the markers to the map. So for adding the markers, what I have done is I used Mapbox documentation to add the markers to the map. So if we go to our account, and if we go to Mapbox.js, there are a lot of examples that they have given that we can do to our map. So what I will be doing is I'll search for a draggable marker, and here they've given the whole documentation of adding a marker. So all we need is this syntax. So we'll take it and then we'll put it in our code. So we'll also turn draggable to false because we don't want to be able to move our markers. The marker should be fixed to the longitude and latitude that is already given from the JSON data. And we'll also add color to the marker. So I'll give the color as red. You can give any color you want. And we'll also set the longitude and latitude to the elements that we declared earlier. So longitude comes first, latitude is the second part. So if we run this, we should see the markers on our map. As you can see, all of the markers have been plotted. So what we'll do now is we'll change the color of the markers so that the places with higher corona show red and the places with less corona cases show a darker color, which could be black. So what I'll do is I'll take the confirmed cases from our document and I'll run a if condition. If cases greater than 2000 or 20,000, then put the color as red. Else you put color as, so in this I will declare a string and in that string I will put the parameter as a string. So what this will do is it will change the color of the marker according to the cases, and in our color feature we'll change it to color. So now our map, if we go on our map, we'll see that the places with less corona have changed their color to a darker version, which is black. Now what we want is, we would want our details of the corona details of the places should be displayed. So what we'll do is we'll create a pop-up variable of mapbox feature. So we'll do var pop-up equal to new. This is the syntax for creating a pop-up. We'll also declare an offset. So what an offset is, that it will decide where on your marker the pop-up will be displayed. So since I want it to be someplace in the middle, so I'll declare the offset as 25, and I will set the text. So we want our positive cases in the pop-up. We'll add a backslash n so that there's line spacing between the details of corona details, and we'll want the recovered cases, and we'll also want the people who have died in that area, so number of people who have died, so that will be the deaths. And since we've used these variables, recovered and death, we need to declare them and store recovered and death from the JSON data. So what we need to do is element dot, we'll just check if death is equal to element dot death and recovered is equal to element dot recovered, and over here also the same. So this should work, and we'll also to the marker we'll add the function dot set pop-up. We'll save this, and now in our HTML document we'll also stat. So I've already done it over here. We'll style the mapbox pop-up to have the maximum width of 75 pixels. So now that we are done with everything, when we run it, we'll get the maps, and the map will display the positive cases, the recovered, and the deaths for all the markers. So that's it for today's workshop. We successfully created a COVID density map. I sincerely hope that you found it useful. If you enjoyed our content, consider hitting the like and subscribe button. And to stay up to date with more of our content, you can follow us on our social media or on our forum. Thanks for watching.